If you're fasting because of Holy Week or just to become healthier, here's a guide on how to do it right in this report by Ara Perez.
A growing number of health experts and doctors are advocating fasting as a tool to lose weight or manage diabetes, while others practice fasting for religious reasons. Some people who have shed the pounds swear by fasting, but many struggle to stick with it. The Philippine Department of Health says fasting, in all its forms and practices, is all about choosing the food that we eat, when to eat, and how much we will be eating.
Pag sinabing choosing the food that we eat, the proper term in Christian language is abstinence, no? So pipili mo, iiwasan mo yung karne, iwasan mo yung manok, ang kakainin mo lang typically gulay or isda. Yan yung nangyayari. Meron siyang effect kasi yung particular profile ng mga pagkain na pinipili or iniiwasan natin, yun yung mga mas mataas sa cholesterol, like red meat for example. It could be higher in cholesterol, or as our oncologists would say, red meat is actually in a way a risk for cancer, colon cancer, pag masyadong maraming red meat na kinakain. So nakakatulong siya in that sense. Plus, if you pair it with fasting or yung ating pagbawas ng dami ng kinakain or sa bilang ng beses na kumakain sa isang araw, yung ating total caloric intake ay bumababa.
But Domingo warns it's not one size fits all. He says there are several factors that need to be considered, especially for people who have underlying health conditions.
Kailangan tingnan natin yung bang fasting angkop ba sa ating pangangatawan, sa ating sitwasyon. Baka tayo ay may sakit. Especially for those of us who have conditions na sinabi ng ating doktor na you have to follow particular eating patterns. Ang ating mga pasyente na diabetic, typically hindi yan basta-basta nagpa-fast kasi at risk sila of both hypo or mababa na sugar, hypoglycemia, or pwede rin silang mag-hyperglycemia. Kasi yung fasting, kapag ikaw ay nag-fast, typically magugutom ka. Tapos pag nag-break yung fast sa ating mga kapatid na Muslim or sa ating mga Katoliko, mga Kristiyano, kapag tayo ay off na yung fasting, kakain tayo, may tendency na okay na kumain. Nagkakaroon yan ng mga surges, mga spikes sa sugar sa ating blood. It really depends on what your particular condition is if you are allowed to do fasting.
But fasting is no longer just a religious practice. It has also become a form of diet for others, more commonly known as intermittent fasting or IF.
Johns Hopkins Medicine defines intermittent fasting or IF as an eating plan that switches between fasting and eating on a regular diet.
Pag sa intermittent fasting, kaya siya sinasabi naging effective kasi yung ating eating window, nagkakaroon tayo ng natural period na umiiwas tayo sa calories at nagiging disiplina siya. So para sa mga ibang tao, kasama na ako siguro doon, mas madali sa akin yung structured na may mga panahon na kakain ako at may mga panahon na hindi ako kakain. Kaysa yung sasabihin ko na babawasan ko yung dami ng kinakain ko.
He believes more studies are needed to conclusively support the reported health benefits of IF.
May mga preliminary studies tayo na nagsasabi na yes, it works. But as to the health benefits, we have to look at it. Ito yung panahon na meron kang makikitang evidence na in-acknowledge naman natin is scientific. Pero like as we always say in medicine, depende yan kung gano'ng karami yung sample size, gano'ng ka well-structured yung study. So may mga criteria na tawag nila is evidence appraisal. Ang ito bang pag-aaral nito ay angkop para sa sangkatauhan na sasabihin natin recommendations ang gagamitin? Or ito bang pag-aaral ito ay ginawa sa ibang bansa kung saan ang pagkain ay iba or ang pangangatawan ng tao ay iba. Yung mga ganyang tanong, doon pa tayo tumitingin at kumbaga inaaral pa natin.
Domingo shares some tips on how to figure out if this regimen will let you achieve your goals or pose a risk to your health.
Ang diet na okay para sa isang tao, hindi siya automatically okay para sa ibang tao. Importante na alam natin yung sitwasyon natin. At sa usapang diet nga is, di ba, calories in, calories out. Ano ba yung available sa atin na pagkain? Ano yung usual schedule natin? Kung ano man yung pinaka-sustainable, pinaka-kaya nating gawin ng pangmatagalan. Mapa-IF man yan, mapa-portion control, meaning tingnan mo nila kung gano'ng karaming kanin or gano'ng karaming karne, gano'ng karaming gulay kinakain mo. Or baka naman kailangan lang sigurong gawin, iwasan natin uminom ng soft drinks. Kasi yung soft drinks, maraming asukal yan eh. So maraming mga paraan para gumawa ng diet na angkop sa atin.
The DOH encourages the public to consult their doctors, nutritionists, or dietitians before engaging in any diet. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
A stage or street play narrating the passion and death of Jesus Christ on the cross is taking place across the country every Holy Week. MJ Felipe talked to some of the actors who have been giving life to some biblical characters in this report.
For 26 years, film and TV actor Royder Camanag has been portraying the role of Christ in the annual Sinakulo. Camanag, together with his brother, has been producing the Sinakulo musical in his hometown in Cavite City as part of his family's devotion.
My family, nag-start silang mamanata. It used to be yung typical na Sinakulo, na yung street. Tapos after 11 years, nag-stop na doon. Then my brother and I, we decided to continue it. And we, instead from street theater, ginawa namin siyang musical.
Camanag said his motivation for doing it varies year after year.
And iba-iba yung mga realizations and discoveries about right. The passion of Christ.
I know, I know.
Nagiging deeper yung meaning.
This year, Camanag is ready for his curtain call. He's already training a new actor to fulfill the role. But what impressed him the most is the amount of dedication the new actors have been showing.
It's always amazing kasi makita mo yung passion ng mga bata and you also learn from them for some reason. Yeah, their energy, their enthusiasm, it's so inspiring.
Like in Camanag's production, most of the actors in Tanghalang Mandaluyong are also young. ABS-CBN News got a glimpse of their rehearsal in this old and abandoned stage in San Jose, Mandaluyong. Everyone was busy polishing their lines, blockings, even the lighting and scoring cues. Their costumes are tucked in a makeshift dresser. We met 34-year-old theater actor Laurent Mercado. He has been giving life to the role of Christ for 13 years. And he takes his craft seriously.
Nung una, nagwiwig pa ako eh. Tapos yung mga ilang years na pinahaba ko na, tapos every mag-Holy Week, papatubo ng big balbas.
Back in 2020, Mercado portrayed the role of Bro in the ABS-CBN series Huwag Kang Mangamba that starred Andrea Brillantes, Francine Diaz, Kyle Chari, and Seth Fedelin. Apart from his lead role, Mercado is also the artistic director of their production. He admits training young and inexperienced actors is hard, but he is driven by the youth's dedication to learn more about Christ.
Gusto ko lang makita ng mga tao yung pagmamahal, yung mga miracles, yung love and sacrifices ni Jesus Christ. Yun lang talaga yung gusto namin every year.
MJ Felipe, ABS-CBN News.
Well, lottery fever is back in the U.S. with the fifth largest jackpot in U.S. history up for grabs. A lucky winner could scoop up $1.1 billion before taxes in the multi-state Mega Millions lottery. Now the winner can either walk away with $520 million in lump sum or spread the payments out over 30 years, paying income tax annually, of course. Here's what some bettors are planning to do if they bag the jackpot.
I would definitely grow it. So I would buy my house, buy my mother a house, a car, buy me a car, and just keep growing with the money, keep flipping the money.
If you had that much money, it'd be tempting to live a lifestyle like you see on TV.
I'm gonna do so much, like stuff I haven't done. I'm gonna do it all at one time.
Six workers who remain missing after the bridge collapse in the city of Baltimore now presumed dead. Emergency responders have suspended search operations, but they will shift to retrieval when they resume Wednesday morning. Now, officials say based on the frigid temperature of the water and the length of time that had passed since the bridge came down, there's little chance that the six missing could be found alive. The Singapore-flagged container ship named Daly knocked down a large section of the Francis Scott Key Bridge, sending vehicles and people into the river below. Rescuers were able to pull two survivors to safety. The ship reported power failure before impact, enabling officials to stop traffic before the collapse.
We're going away from the search and rescue portion to a recovery operation. The changing conditions out there have made it dangerous for the first responders, the divers in the water. We will still have surface ships out overnight. At 0600 hours tomorrow, we're hoping to put divers in the water and begin a more detailed search to do our very best to recover those 6 missing people. We're going to do everything in our power to help these families find closure.
The accident has shut down one of the busiest ports on the eastern seaboard. The U.S. transportation chief admits rebuilding will not be easy.
The federal government will provide all of the support that they need for as long as it takes. This is no ordinary bridge. This is one of the cathedrals of American infrastructure. It has been part of the skyline of this region for longer than many of us have been alive. So the path to normalcy will not be easy. It will not be quick. It will not be inexpensive. But we will rebuild together.
U.S. President Joe Biden commending the quick response of the U.S. Coast Guard and the fast action of Maryland officials, which prevented an even bigger tragedy. Biden says he will send all the federal resources needed to handle the incident, adding the federal government will shoulder the cost of rebuilding. Biden also addressing speculations the incident was a deliberate attack.
It's my intention that federal government will pay for the entire cost of reconstructing that bridge. And I expect the Congress to support my effort. Everything so far indicates that this was a terrible accident. At this time, we have no other indication, no other reason to believe there's any intentional act here.